हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर सिराजुल फैसी। आई वेलकम यू इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर एंड आई होप दिस वीडियो विल बी हेल्पफुल टू यू। इफ़ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो देन सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल। सो फ्रेंड, लेट अस टू स्टार्ट एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर। So objective of this talk is Deleterious ideas about the atoms, Dalton's atomic theory, identify what instrument is used to observe individual atoms. The Greek philosopher Democritus was among the first to suggest the existence of atoms, from the Greek word atomos. He believed that atoms were indivisible and indestructible. His idea did agree with the later scientific theory, but did not explain chemical behavior and was not based on the scientific method, but just philosophy. So, Dalton's atomic theory, experiment based. All elements are composed of tiny individual particles called atoms. Atoms of the same elements are identical. Atoms of any two elements are different from those of any other elements. Atoms of different elements combine in simple whole number ratio to form chemical compounds. In chemical reactions, atoms are combined, separated, or rearranged, but never combined. So friends, sizing up the atoms. Elements are able to be subdivided into smaller and smaller particles, and these are the atoms, and they still have properties of the elements. If you could line up copper atoms in a single file, they would be approximately 1 centimeter long. Despite their small size, individual atoms are observable with instruments such as scanning tunneling electrons. So identify the three types of subatomic particles. Describe the structure of atoms according to the Rutherford atomic model. One change to Dalton's atomic theory is that atoms are divisible into subatomic particles, electrons, protons and neutrons. So, discovery of electrons. In 1897, J.J. Thomson used a cathode ray tube to deduce the presence of a negatively charged particles, the electrons. Cathode, slits, high voltage, positive plate, negative plate, anode. Modern cathode ray tubes, television, computer monitors. Cathode ray tube passes electricity through the gas that contains at a so mass of electrons. The oil drop apparatus, you can see the mass of electron is 9.11 × 10⁻²³ grams. So Robert Millikan determined the mass of electrons. 1 by 1840, the mass of a hydrogen atom has 1 unit of negative. So friend, conclusion from the study of electrons. Cathode rays have identical properties regardless of the elements used to produce them. All elements must contain identically charged electrons. Atoms are neutrals, so there must be positive particles in the atoms to balance the negative charge of the electrons. Electrons have so little mass that atoms must contain other particles. So conclusion from the study of the electrons. Eugen Goldstein in 1886 observed what is now called the protons, particles with a positive charge and a relative mass of 1840 times that of an electron. 1932, James Chadwick confirmed the existence of the neutrons, a particle with no charge but mass. So subatomic particles, electrons, protons and neutron, electron e minus, p plus, n n 0, charge minus 1 plus 1 0, mass 9.11 into 10 to minus 28, 1.67 into 10 to minus 24, 1.67 into 10 to minus 24, electron clot, nucleus. So Thomson atomic model, J.J. Thomson believed that the electrons were like plums embedded in a positively charged pudding. You can see here. So Rutherford's gold foil experiments, 1911. So gold foil, you can see, and detective screen, slits, and alpha particles emitted. So alpha particles are helium nuclei. The alpha particles were filtered, fired at a thin sheet of gold foil, particles that hit on the detector. So Rutherford's problems. In the following picture, there is a target hidden by a cloud. The figure out the shape of the target. We shoot some beam into the cloud and recorded where the beam came out. Can you figure out the shape of the target? You see the target, and you can see the situations. So target 1 and target 2. So Rutherford findings. Most of the particles passed right through. A few particles were deflected. A very few were greatly deflected. Like how we see shells bouncing off the tissue paper. So conclusion. The nucleus is small. The nucleus is dense. And nucleus is positively charged. So Rutherford atomic model based on his experimental evidence. The atom is mostly empty space, all positive charge and almost all the mass is concentrated in a small area in the center. He called this a nucleus. The nucleus is composed of protons and neutrons. They make the nucleus. The electrons distributed around the nucleus and occupy most of the volume. His model was called nuclear models. So distinguish among atoms. What is the objective? Explain what makes elements and isotopes different from each other. Calculate the number of neutrons in an atom. Calculate the atomic mass of an element. Explain why chemists use the periodic table. So atomic number. Atoms are composed of identical protons, neutrons and electrons. How then are atoms of one element different from the another elements? Elements are different because they contains different number of protons. The atomic number of an element is the number of protons in the nucleus. So friend, the atomic number of an element is the number of protons in the nucleus of each atom of that element. You can see carbon, phosphorus, gold, number of protons 6, 15, 79, atomic 6, 15, 79. So mass number. Mass number is the number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus of an isotopes. Nucleides P plus, N0, E minus. So oxygen 18, 18, 8, 18, arsenic and phosphorus. So complete symbol contains the symbol of the elements, the mass number and the atomic number. Superscript mass number, subscript atomic number. So symbols. Find each of these, number of protons, number of neutrons, number of electrons, atomic number, mass number. So if an element has an atomic number of 34 and mass number of 78, what is the number of protons, number of neutrons, number of electrons and complete symbol? So if an element has 91 protons and 140 neutrons, what is the atomic number, mass number, number of electrons, complete symbol? So if an element has 78 electrons, 117 neutrons, what is the atomic number, mass number, number of protons, complete symbol? Now isotopes. Dalton was wrong about all elements of the same types being identical. Atoms of the same elements can have different number of neutrons. Thus different mass numbers. So those are called isotopes. So Friedrich Soddy proposed the idea of isotopes in 1912. Isotopes are the atom of the same elements having different masses due to varying number of neutrons. Soddy won the Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 1921 for his work with naming isotope. We can also put the mass number after the name of the elements: carbon-12, carbon-14, uranium-235. So isotopes are atom of the same elements having different masses due to varying number of neutrons. You can see hydrogen-1, protium, hydrogen-2, deuterium, hydrogen-3, tritium, and neutron-0, 1, 2. Now isotopes elements occur in the nature as mixture of isotopes. Isotopes are atom of the same elements that differ in the number of neutrons. So hydrogen 1 proton, helium 2 proton, lithium 3 protons. Now atomic mass. How heavy is an atom of oxygen? It depends because there are different kind of oxygen atom. We are more concerned with the average atomic mass. This is based on the abundance percentage of each variety of that element in nature. We don't use gram for this mass because the number would be too small. So measuring atomic mass, instead of grams, the unit we use is the atomic mass unit. It is defined as the 1/12 the mass of carbon-12 atoms. Carbon-12 chosen because of its isotope purity. Each isotope has its own atomic mass, thus we determine the average from the percentage abundance. To calculate the average, multiply the atomic mass of each isotope by its abundance, expressed as a decimal, then add the results. If not told otherwise, the mass of the isotope is expressed in atomic mass unit. So atomic mass. Atomic mass is the average of all naturally occurring isotopes of the elements. Symbols, composition of nucleus, percentage in nature. Carbon-12, carbon-13, carbon-14. You see, 6 protons, 6 neutrons, 6 protons, 7 neutrons, 6 protons, 8 neutrons. You see the percentage. Less than 0.01, 1.11, 98.89. So, calculating atomic mass. Element X has two natural isotopes. The isotope with a mass of 10.012 mu has a relative abundance of 19.91. The isotope with the mass of this, so you can calculate like this: isotope, mass, relative abundance, and then you have to do calculations. So describe the origin of the periodic table, identify the position of group, period, and transition metal in the periodic table. Dmitry Mendeleev listed the elements in column in order of increasing mass. You can see periodic table and arrangement of the elements according to similarities in properties. So mostly determine the atomic number of atoms of elements. So period, what is period? Horizontal law of the periodic tables. There are 7 periodic law. When the elements are arranged in order of increasing atomic number, there is a periodic repetition of their physical and chemicals. So modern periodic table. Group vertical up and down, column elements in the periodic table. The elements in any group of the periodic tables have similar physical and chemical property. Each group is identical in number and letter A and B, and group A elements are called representative elements. And these elements can be divided into three broad masses: metal, you know the metal characteristic, non-metals, and metalloids. You can see here non-metals, metalloid. So rather than the memorizing more than 100 elements, you need to only learn a general behavior and trend within the major groups. So friends, hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel, and thanks for watching.